Thank you, Cathaoirleach. Well, Minister, Christmas should be a time that's happy for families and for everybody, but unfortunately it's a time when violence against women flares up in a dramatic way. It's a time when, according to Women's Aid, fear, intimidation, casual cruelty, sudden flashes of violence and threats of well-being to children, children being used as pawns for control and intimidation. That's unfortunately what's facing many women in the next few weeks. And I think the statistics that have been cited are indeed shocking, but they're probably actually much higher than we really believe. Internationally, at least one in three women, that's up to 1 billion women, have been beaten, coerced into sex, or otherwise abused in their lifetime. In Ireland, the figures are 1 in 4 to 1 in 5 who have been victims of domestic violence. But what's very worrying is, rather than this problem getting better, it seems to be getting worse, we'd have to say. Because in one survey that was done in the UK, 1 in 4 teenagers reported they had experienced violence from their boyfriends or partners. And I think that this is a huge problem in society that we have to blow open and discuss in a major way. And violence isn't just physical. As serious is psychological, sexual and financial violence against women. It may not sound as serious, but how would you like to be threatened? You know, that your house will be set on fire, that your partner will commit suicide, continually blamed, stalked, harassed, called names and even imprisoned in your own house, not allowed to use a car, etc. They're all psychological forms of violence. And indeed, on a wider basis, 55% of women have been sexually harassed in their own workplace, which I think just shows the level of violence against women that's out there. The Minister may have seen a video, I think it's gone viral, of a woman walking down the street in New York, and the amount of intimidation and abuse that she suffered casually from men who had no compunction about making comments to her. I'm not saying that's the same in Ireland, but I would hazard a guess that it is for many women. And it's also appalling that 1 in 8 pregnant women will experience violence, because actually pregnancy can be another trigger for a man to be violent to a woman. And I think we have to really move away from the almost exclusive focus on the victim. And by that I mean, stop looking at why does she leave, why does she put up with it, and reduce our victim blame culture that's endemic in this society, widespread even among some women. There has to be an absolutely zero tolerance for violence against women of any kind. Not excusing it, not minimising it, not trying to put it in a context, etc. And I think we have to understand, and maybe we haven't, and there needs to be a discussion opened up in society, the very clever nature of violent men. In one report that was done in 2012 by John Hennessy, called How He Gets Into Her Head, The Mind of the Male Intimate Abuser, he contended that violent men are more skillful and more determined than most paedophiles. And in fact, they manipulate and they groom women to be victims of violence in the future. And I think that's really important that it's understood. Now in Ireland, we've the highest rate in Europe for not meeting women's needs when they seek help. We've only got a third of the refuge spaces, as we know, but there's a whole array of other supports that are needed. Now, obviously, the austerity and the homeless crisis is making it completely worse. It's impossible, and coming across it myself, to give women advice and to find places for them to go. We've seen the cuts to Dundalk and in Wexford, the refuges there. And just to finish, I do welcome anything the Minister has announced today about liaison officers in Garda districts and so on. I've experienced myself Gardaí not being available in Dublin 15 and Blanchardstown to respond to breaches of barring orders. There's no cars available. So there's ongoing cuts to the Gardaí that's also exacerbating the problem. And just finally, sorry, Ken Corlett, to say, you know, capitalism breeds violence, because as long as you have a system where women are completely economically and socially subservient to men all around the globe, they are going to be victims of violence. And I think the rape culture that we've seen in popular culture is extremely worrying, and it's something that deserves a lot more discussion than the few minutes that we're devoting to it.
Thank you, Deputy.